I'm Rupert McLaren.
I'm James Ward.
I'm Nick O'Leary.
I'm Ainsley Payton.
I'm Caitlin Everett.
Noah Saheli.
I'm Lana Kavanaugh.
I'm Harrison Robertson.
I'm Grace Malloy. Welcome.
Welcome.
Welcome. Welcome to the...
To the 2021.
To the 2021.
2021 Woodleigh Arts Week Film Festival.
Film Festival.
Film Festival.
Enjoy the films.
So my short film, Olive and Charles, is inspired by the Romeo and Juliet typical Hollywoodized boy and girl who fall in love and run away together stories, except I've tried to add in some anti-Hollywood elements and conventions, so look out for those. The film takes big inspiration from directors such as Wes Anderson and Greta Gerwig, whose coming-of-age style storybook movies I hope shine through, particularly in the aesthetic of the film. The soundtrack is also an important element, as I've used two French songs, taking inspiration from cinematic French films with minimal dialogue, as well as French and languages in general being a personal passion of mine. There isn't too much of a deep meaning, but I don't want to spoil the ending, so just enjoy.
Trickery and Treachery. It's a film about crime, gangster, and all of the other things. It was a very calming experience creating this film.
Jesus Christ! The hell is a Premiere Pro and what are they a pro in?
F***ing hell.
What's wrong with me, Nick? Any of this mean?
You know what? I'm calm. I'm really, really sorry about that, guys. I'm sorry. It's a film.
Ah!
Isn't that just a fun time?
Film. Films. Film. No. I am eligible for the COVID payment, okay? I want a Segway. Okay, so my film...
Simon Cow.
Okay, my film is now called Snake in the Grass. It's no longer tricky, it's Snake in the Grass. Yeah, so COVID happened, but enjoy.
Yeah. Paul Russo. I guess you realised it wasn't worth running. You don't need to see this, but you're looking at it.
Is there a problem, officer?
You know, you're not big enough in the world of crime for there to be any problems. You know I can't arrest you for driving.
Did you just come here to make fun of my profession, cop?
Listen, Paul, I've dealt with guys much tougher than you. I just came here to ask you a few questions. Questions about...
About the night it all went to shit.
Yeah, basically, you're the only one there who can tell the tale.
Okay, it all started...
Black covers for 100 bad men, 100 black grapes so I can lay they ass in. I need 100 black preachers with a black sermon to tell from 100 black Bibles. Why we send them all to hell? I need 100 black covers. Black covers. Black covers. Black covers.
Jimmy the Taipan Hill. He had the hardest job of everyone in the gang. He basically did everything for the boss, like set up this war of a meeting that was about to go down. The kid had the guts to hold a gun, but never man enough to pull the trigger.
Everyone should be here soon, Mr. Wong.
So basically you're saying this Jimmy guy was the Don's kiss ass?
We can agree on that, but he did it well.
I'm not here to be your friend, Russo.
Right, right. Sat in the car, patiently waiting.
That's life. That's what all the people say.
Hey, yo, Tommy's home. I was just around the corner finishing something up. See, that last guy, he was a sprayer. I'll tell you that much.
So in walks the biggest asshole of the organization, Tommy Big Boy Angelo, the Don's personal hitman. He would collect the money from the dinners and also just whack any guy that Don needed whacking.
You're here early?
Better than being late. I thought you'd be happy.
I'd be happy if you weren't even here. But this is how things are gonna go.
Well, I'm a professional rat catcher.
Well, you're not here to catch rats. Just make sure you're not one yourself, Tommy.
Peter Double P. Pierce, a real rough and tough bruiser. He's the head of the distribution scene. He hires street kids to sell his shit and he gives the money to Don Wong. It's unethical, but it was damn good business.
Sake.
Don, I didn't know the flute was invited.
Yeah, well I only came because I get to see you, Petey.
I can't wait to find out you're the rat so that I get the privilege of ripping off your ears and shoving them up your
ass. Well, calm down, Petey, alright? Let's not make this harder than it has to be. How about we take this outside, Petey? Unless you need one of your goons to help you out.
I don't need any help dragging your small frame up and down the pavement.
Here's a guy you wouldn't see every day, Armored Ghoul Bates, in charge of all the analytics, money handling, and laundering. Don Juan respected him the most because he never made a mistake. But damn, the guy was frightening.
The Don welcomes you, Mr. Bates. Okay, finally, we can begin. I'm sure you all know why you're here.
a recent case is open surrounding the Laoban Wong crime organization. And it occurs to us that there has to be a rat. And that rat has to be one of you three. We know this because the police know information that is far too deep for any lowlife like Paulie to know about.
When I'm back on top.
So, the Don has organized some questions for you three to answer. Number one, have you ever been caught by the police?
Once for theft, twice for aggravated assault.
Nope, never. Same here. What, I'm being honest?
I was driving my boys to the bar for a little celebration. We just sold a crap ton of the good stuff.
As usual, I was counting the Don's money. I whacked this guy. Hey, Pete. You tell your guys anything? Maybe it was one of them.
Don't question me about my guys.
All I'm saying is I think we have the right. If it was one of them. You're being a little defensive about him. Maybe it was you!
I think we've all had just about enough of your stupid antics, big boy. You want to be a man and take this outside?
All I'm saying is that we should have the right to walk in here
and question on them!
What does he do?
So, after you heard the gunshots, you drove off, and now all five of them are dead.
I don't know. I wasn't in the room. It just got all quiet.
Hello, Paul.
You? You were the rat?
Well, more of a snake in the grass.
So that's why they call you the Taipan.
Yeah, it could be. I see you met my friend Detective Longo. I hired him to ask you some questions to see if you were loyal or not. You see, the thing is, Paul, I wasn't the rat. I just took the opportunity where I saw fit. You see, I know I wasn't the rat, because even though I killed the Don, I sure as hell respected his reputation. After the way you spilled that story today, I know you were the rat. What's the matter, Paul? Am I still the Don's kiss ass?
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June. I said that's life.
That's life.
It may seem some people get their kicks stomping on a dream, but I don't let it get me down, 'cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around.
Where have you been?
Got a mad attitude. Smells good.
But it's raining outside.
Even sir, there's literally a lightning storm.
It's God's plan, dude. Let's go with it.
Hi. So my film is a surf film. There is a lot of surfing in it. Some people say there is too much surfing, but I guess what is a surf film without surfing? There's a bunch of drone shots, a bunch of surf montages. It's probably what people are saying about there being too much surfing in the surf film. It's a lot of surf montages. But where's the surf genre without surf montages? So I think it makes up a lot of the film. It makes up the narrative of the film. But if we can get past that, I hope my film can bring the audience joy and happiness through the atmosphere it makes, through the cinematography and the music paired with it, which is really just nice acoustic. It just fits the vibe really well. The narrative may come across a little cheesy, but that's the whole joy of it, and it's expected, but I hope for the audience to fall in love with the characters and just like be immersed in the whole experience of the film, because it was fun to make. I enjoyed making it. It made me inspired more to pursue film and made me believe in myself more to pursue film as well. And I hope you guys enjoy it, because it took a while to make. Took my whole holidays, you know. Just don't leave your editing your media film until last 2 weeks of holidays, yeah. Sorry, every other subject, I didn't get to those practice exams, but you know, we can get through that. I hope you guys enjoy the film.
Today's surf conditions are near perfect. There's a northern wind coming off the cliffs, complementing the slight southern swell. Perfect for those wanting to practice for tomorrow's board rider junior title. Next, we talk to a local legend about his signature bottom turn.
You just gotta commit to the wave. You just have to let it guard you.
Sometimes I have no idea what you mean. It'll be fine. It'll come to me tomorrow.
I'm sure of it.
Today's conditions are perfect for our competitors today for the junior titles as we get the first heat started.
Come on.
Morgan White advances to the next round. Congratulations to the other competitors, but today, you don't get to advance to the next round.
You didn't see that, did you?
Sorry, dude. It's all the whole thing.
I can't do this.
Do you remember when you won the under 12 championships? You were great.
Yeah, the under 12s was 6 years ago. I suck now.
Dude, you gotta stop fighting it. When you go under, you just gotta pop back up and take a breath.
Whatever.
I was mid.
Okay.
Say action mid. It makes it all feel more natural.
It does.
You know what they say, always work with children and dogs.
Music. What is music? What is music? Music is expression. Music is art.
But what does music look like? What does music feel like? Why does a musician come back to music? What is the drive for a musician? What does that love of an instrument look like, feel like? Well, that is what my new film, Hearing in Color, explores. Sound in color. Sound in color. A film about sound in color and music and being a musician and juggling work and school. It's a film about juggling school, everybody. Enjoy!
You're gonna miss the bus. Bye.
Bye.
Have a good day. Hey, how was your day?
Yeah, I was all right.
Dad and I are going to bed. Make sure you don't stay up too late.
I won't. Next week?
Maybe. I've got a piece, but it's not very good.
You should. We want to see you play.
Show.
Thanks, Mum.
See you out there.
So, what have you come to talk to me about today? I'm, not happy with the film I'm making. And why is that? I don't know, it's, I think the problem is that it's amateurish. I mean, of course it was going to be amateurish. I'm a student, it's a student film, and I'm an amateur, but it's not amateur in a bad way. It's not amateur in a good way. What makes something amateur in the good way? Maybe Wes Anderson's first film, Bottle Rocket? Not the feature-length Bottle Rocket one, the one in 1996. I'm talking the original Bottle Rocket, the 13-minute one. It was filmed back in 1992, just by Wes. On a black and white camera, because that's all that he could afford at the time. And you know, Luke and Owen Wilson had never acted before. This was their first thing, so it was, acting was a tiny bit off, but it was just so campy and lovable, and there was this spark about it, and even back then, you could tell that it was something special, that Wes Anderson was something special. And why do you think yours is amateur in the bad way? I think it's trying too hard. It's trying too hard to be something that it physically can't be, that it isn't. I went in and I shot it like it was this Hollywood action-filled blockbuster film, but it's not. It's just me behind the camera, and it's easy to see that people don't get lost in it because they can see the facade. Don't you think maybe it's you just looking through it because you made it? Because you can see everything wrong with it? I always get told that I'm my own worst critic, and that's my problem, but what does it matter if I'm my own worst critic? At least I'm not up my own ass and refuse to take any criticism on my work. Like, if I work to please my worst critic, then it's just going to be that much better to everybody who isn't my worst critic. But people say that your work is good. People like your work. It's not bad. It is bad. You need to stop being so hard on yourself. I can't just stop being hard on myself. That isn't how it works. It's like telling somebody who's sad to just stop being sad. That isn't how it works. It's not going to work. All it's going to do is it's going to make them bottle it up and try and send it away, but it won't work. A man can pick up and throw away whatever he wants, but he's still going to be left with his hands. So what are you going to do? I don't know. The more I think about my film, I just feel sick. Just want to start again. Try again.
No, don't do that. Just
finish what you've got. They've already said that what you've got is good.
I don't care. All my life I've looked for validation for everything I've ever done. When I was a kid, I would run to my parents to show them what I'd done so they would tell me that it was good. I wanted them to tell me that I was good. I couldn't imagine living for anything other than external validation, but it doesn't work anymore. It doesn't work anymore. I just want to be happy with something I make. I just want to make something good, something that I think is good. That's all I want.
But you do make things that are good.
I don't. I keep thinking that I can, and that's my problem, isn't it? I keep thinking that I can make something good, but I can't. That's my problem.
No, you want to know what your problem is? Your problem is that you're Grace Malloy. Your problem is that you're a perfectionist. Your problem is that no matter how many times people tell you that they like what you've made, you dismiss it. Your problem is that you're Grace Malloy, and that means that you will never, ever be happy with anything that you make because you hate yourself. Your problem is that you're Grace Malloy, and nothing ever pleases her.
I know.
Good afternoon, Violet.
You got a job for me?
Indeed. I have several. You may take your pick. Bail Jumper in the Decala system. Bail Jumper on Lixifus. Escapee in the Chuthera system. Broke Marks in the Gwenope system. Bail Jumper.
You gotta know none of these are worth my time, B.
I was hoping you'd say that. There is another job that might be more your speed.
Why isn't there a picture?
No image available. The only thing I can offer is the last known coordinates. The bounty was last seen in the Sayama system.
And the pay for this mystery job?
80 chrono credits is the advertised price.
Shoot, well, can't pass up a pay like that.
The job has been accepted. The coordinates have been sent to your device. It has been requested that you begin as soon as possible.
That works for me.
Best wishes, Violet.
I sent you the job! I sent you the job!
What? Why are you here?
It's not a bounty job. It's not a bounty job.
What?
It's an escort job. I need you to escort me.
I don't do escorts. Why didn't you contact someone who does?
They'd need to see my face. I'd have to give over a lot of information. I can't afford to do that.
Why not?
I'm ex-Federation. I escaped. I'm off the grid, but this is my chance to leave for good. I have a contact waiting beyond the border that's going to help me, but I need to leave now, or they won't be there when I reach the fence.
Federation soldiers are trained. Why would you need me to escort you?
I'm injured. If something happened or someone found me, I won't be able to do anything to protect myself. Like I said, I can't wait for it to heal.
Okay, even so, I don't do escorts. Find someone who does.
Not even for, 80 creds?
100.
85.
100.
95.
100.
100.
110?
100!
Deal. You're lucky I hate the Federation.
Yeah, my shoulder feels pretty lucky.
It should. I could have broke it.
Yeah, I don't doubt it. Can we stop? My leg is killing me.
Power through it.
Okay, we're stopping.
I wasn't planning on this escort mission being a mini vacation.
We're only gonna be here for a little bit. We got a whole day before we get to the border. What difference is an hour gonna make? Shit.
What?
Keep your voice down.
What?
Federation soldiers just started their night shift.
I knew you shouldn't have let us rest.
How the hell was I supposed to know? I do. I left ages ago. Okay, you're escorting me.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, it's probably nothing, but I'll check it out anyway.
You had a gun this whole time?
Didn't leave the Federation without nothing. I didn't know you could laugh.
I can. You're just not funny.
I'm very funny. Take your jacket back. People think I'm very funny.
Yep, this is me, And at this exact moment, I had finally realized my school film was a complete disaster. It is Saturday, the 8th of May, and today is the first day of filming my media film. My mum and dad have just left to go on a holiday. I have finished my screenplay, cleaned out my brother's old bedroom and turned it into a film set, and now I am just waiting for my two friends to arrive at my house any second now. And that really was strange, because I just remembered I took trains to come home from school yesterday. Actually, I didn't really care. And more importantly, both of my friends had finally arrived at my house. We talked some business, had some pizza for dinner, watched heaps of movies, and then eventually went to bed. Today is the actual first day of filming my media film. The first scene to film was the opening train scene inside of Chelsea train station. And as soon as me and my friends had arrived to the train station to film, it turns out it had actually gotten completely demolished the moment we got there. We got home, and while Tucker and Louie were playing PlayStation, I was at my desk, stuck.
What am I gonna do?
I'm so confused.
What the f***?
Half of my media film is inside a train. I just don't know what to do.
Please don't ask me about my media film.
Oh, he's gonna ask me. If he asks me, I haven't done anything.
Hey, son, it's Mum and I.
Hi, Josh. How you going?
Hey, Mum. Hey, Dad.
How's the filming coming along? Have you got anything done?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I've been doing so much filming. Heaps. Oh, it's great.
Okay, well, Mum and I will be home tomorrow afternoon. Please make sure that your mates have gone by then. All right, we'll see you then. Bye, son.
See you tomorrow, Josh. Bye.
Yeah, all right. See ya.
And at that exact time, I had no footage of anything at all. So I told my friends, we should just film something while we still have the chance.
Action.
Oh yeah, that was really, really good.
Cool.
Oh yeah, we
that's,
need
that's
okay. Could you turn the light off and then you just go whenever you're ready?
And although neither of us three had any f***ing idea what we were doing, just having the ability to film something was so satisfying.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
I just realized that Tucker's in the background of this shot the whole time. Oops. My friends next day went home and we all agreed to catch up again a week later to film the rest of my movie. But then...
A few weeks ago, that the Chief Health Officer and the Public Health Team have recommended to me and my Cabinet colleagues that we lock Victoria down from 11:59pm tonight until 11:59pm next Tuesday night.
And again...
So from 11:59 tonight, there are 5 reasons to leave home, not 4.
And again...
I have a new series of stage 4 restrictions to announce, and I'll do Metro Melbourne first.
And it had still been months, and we're still in lockdown. And I had finally realised that my entire media film was a complete disaster. That I need to make a film about this, because it's perfect.
My film is an experimental narrative, coming-of-age horror music video, which deals with the concept of losing somebody, but kind of more specifically how we can latch onto a person that we used to know when they've changed, and kind of figuring out how we can let go of them and not allowing the end of a relationship to ruin us. My film's initial concept was quite heavily inspired and developed by the music video Human by Dodie, because it features some really beautiful dreamy lighting as it deals with a woman who is building her lover, but by the end of it, he isn't interested in her anymore. This is where my dreamy aesthetic with overexposed white lighting and high frames per second rate so I can slow down the footage and the kind of more careful movements of the music video stemmed from. And that carried over when I was planning the treatment for my music video. I was really drawn to this because my song is called It All Just Stays the Same, And, you know, the meaning has like this duality about it where everything the narrator tries to change stays the same. And like they kind of feel stuck in the life that they've made for themselves. But also the idea that they're trying to figure out when the best moment is to change somebody else's mind or opinion about something, which brought my focus to the idea of fire and how, like, when somebody else's fire is out, it kind of signifies that their passion or belief system is dying out, and they don't feel as strongly about that topic anymore. And that's kind of how the fire was introduced in my film, which I think really ties together my character's emotional state in the music video, because he doesn't want his relationship to change and he wants to keep latching onto her, but she's more curious about, you know, what this fire is and kind of exploring other options.
I just became a bitter, pissed that I missed the picture. I'm into it the way you want, yeah. Cause you're such a straight shooter. So many candles, white or black. When the fire's out, we're all just whacked. Space in the room, it's straight by the cracks. I told you to run it back.
Try it, try it, try it, try it, try it, try it. Things are loose.
The sun's shining. There's no cloud inside.
Yeah, I guess you could say it's nice. What about my
room? Hey, what do you want?
Well, you know that basketball game that came out on the PS5 last week? The one that I really wanted and I told you about?
Yeah, what about it?
I was just wondering if I was gonna maybe be able to play it tonight.
Why would I know that?
Well, I don't know, I just thought you might know.
Okay, well, I literally have zero clue, so I don't know.
Sure thing, you have zero clue. Good one. Okay, well, bye to you too.
Luca, I just finished that. Girl, what's your problem?
Sorry, I was just thinking about how much I love balloons. They're really fun, and especially when you're celebrating.
Okay, why are you telling me this?
You're just in my mind. Can I not stay my bed and call to you?
Well, if you're done, can you leave? Thanks.
Fine, bye then.
Hey Lucy, just letting you know that I'm going to be heading out for 30 minutes.
Okay.
Okay, well, I hope there's going to be a cake when I get back. Bye!
Wait, what cake? Oh my god. Hi, can I order a cake? Yeah, could it be dropped off in the next half an hour? Yeah, I'm serious. Hello, could I order a cake that can be ready in half an hour? No? Okay, thanks anyways. Hi, would I be able to have one of your cakes delivered? And is there any chance it could be ready in half an hour? You have one left? Great, I'll take it.
This is so great! For a second there I thought you forgot.
No.
Yeah, it's fine. Let's cut the cake open.
Okay. That's kind of funny, don't you think?
Yeah,
I didn't think. It's really small.
It's so nice though.
Thank you.
Why are you here? To see a movie? To be entertained? Haha. To fill the endless void that's inside of us? You have questions, and I'm supposed to say, the film's basically a love letter to anyone with a passion, and it's just about two kids who play a game of chess, and it's really nothing more than that besides a comparison between two contrasting people. No! It's meaningless. Ladies and gentlemen, this movie that you're about to watch is a masterclass in why you should prepare before filming. And stuff like that. Please, prepare yourselves for the game.
As of 7 a.m. this morning, the Earth's current population is 7,867,995,050. Estimating 17% of those people fall between the age groups of 15 and 17, lowering that number to 453,777,002 people. According to my recent National Assessment Program of Literacy and Numeracy, NAP plan, I fall in the top 2% of students, meaning... I am better than 453,999,022 people.
Eddie, put these on the table.
This is my current collection of chess competition awards. Frankston, undefeated. Mount Eliza, undefeated. Mornington, fourth place. But enough about me. For the last 3 years, I've been working my bum off to become the best chess player in the world and decimate my greatest enemy, Sam. This arseface has made their life goal to destroy everything that makes me cool, practicing day and night purely to try and beat me in chess. Anyway, you've heard enough about Sam. Let's get back on track. I've been playing chess.
What? What the hell's that? The sound?
Oh, it is on.
Did you know that nutmeg is actually poisonous?
It actually what?
It's actually poisonous.
Oh no. Walk along the razor's edge.
But don't look down, just keep your head.
Thank you.
Sorry I'm late.
Your pawn structure is a jamble. You're 6 pieces down, and with your average move time being 46 seconds, I predict I'll win in 9 moves, equating to 7 minutes and 12 seconds.
Oh, that sucks. Because you've only got 39 seconds left on your clock. Oh, Eddie, you just hung your rook.
Draw.
Okay. Again?
If she's unconscious and powerless, if she's not a problem for a man. Wherefore thou morals gone, thought fairy tales were happy. Late at night I toss my turn, is this all the life can be? Tony the hero, been holding out for the hero since Maleficent came. And I've been sleeping here, cursed for so many years, and I know it's time for a change. Don't even...
Who? Cinderella? Nah, she's always studying and she never goes out to any of the parties or nothing. I need a girl who doesn't think as much. Sleeping Beauty, on the other hand, she's easy!
We can be more than this life! Belle, Pinocchio, Mr. Wolf, even you, Little Red, we can't stay here forever. Don't you want to live beyond your pages? Hear me out! The tale of Little Red Riding Hood. In the forest behind Red was a dark shadow, always lurking, always approaching. Little Red did not know what a wicked creature he was. No shit! Women should be able to walk alone without the fear of being murdered! Since time began, fairy tales have misconstrued, exploited, and sexualized us. And most of us are only young girls. Snow White's 14! Don't need a hero! Been lost enough for a hero, loving you for your grace. It is your right self that makes you beautiful in some kind of fucked up way. Don't need a hero! Snow White had lips as red as a rose. Like me. Hair as black as ebony. Like me. And skin as white as snow. She was the fairest in all of the land. How come it's only white people who are the fairest in the land? Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair. I'm sorry, out of respect for myself and the Quran, no. My hair is private and I only share it with my family. I cover my hair because I am proud of my Muslim identity. How about you show me what a strong and handsome man you are by climbing up here without using my hair? Then maybe we can live happily ever after. Happily ever after. Just because our fairy tales are traditional, that doesn't mean we can't change them. There are so many examples of women who've created a destiny beyond what the world had written for them. Christine Jorgensen, Life magazine here. We've been after a transsexual dude for quite some time now. Why are you wanting to pose nude on next month's cover? What bits do you actually have down there? Christine Jorgensen, Christine Jorgensen. New York Daily News. Is it true that your parents' dying words of them disowning you? Christine Jorgensen, you must have massive balls. Demand an apology from the vice president for calling you a guy. Why should we have to change because you're not comfortable?
Does she have balls?
Ladies and gentlemen, many years ago when I was playing at the Latin Quarter, there was a beautiful show which opened on Broadway called Flower Drum Song. In it, Patizuki sang this wonderful tune, which became my theme song. Sing along if you know it. I'm a girl, and by me that's only great. I enjoy that my silhouette in curves, and I walk the sweet and girlish gait. Pipe down, sonny. Ooh, I enjoy being a girl. Mama, I detest being a girl. Teach me to read and write. You know I want more than this life. I can do more than just tend les jardins. Mon Dieu! Mama, it is me, Jean. Mama, it's the person. And that's when I thought a light brighter than I'd ever seen. The Archangel Michael. And in that moment I knew, even though I was just a little girl, I would lead the French army to victory. Now the flames, they follow Joan of Arc. As she came, riding through the dark, no moon to keep her armor bright. Don't need a man to get her through this very smoky night. We need to rise from the ashes just as Joan did, out of our traditional roles. I'm tired of being told I need a hero.
Thank you. Well, folks, that brings us to the close of the 2021 Woodleigh Arts Festival. Thank you again for your support. Once again, COVID has had a significant impact on our ability to produce this event. Our students at a Unit 4 level have had less than 10 classes on site, so what they've been able to produce in that time has been truly remarkable. I'd like to give a huge personal thanks to Adam Lydiard, to Birralee Ward, Caroline Grove, Jeff Rogers, Kerry Saunders, Anthony Bingham and Amy White for all of their support and work behind the scenes with the students for them to be able to get their finalised products for your viewing pleasure this evening and across this week. Once the pandemic begins to lift and life returns to a bit more of resembling normal, I strongly urge, plead, beg for you to go and support your arts community. They were the first ones out, pretty much, and they'll be one of the last industries back in terms of resuming their full function. And they will need your support. So when things become a little bit looser, please go see a show, go see a gig, support everybody you can. And thank you again for being such a supportive member of the Woodleigh Arts community.